Hey mathematicians, it's Justin again. Welcome back to the Miaville Art Museum. Mia and I are checking out the next part of the Mathematical Masterpieces exhibit, and this time, it's interactive. We'll be using what we learn about different shapes to create our own original artwork. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to name polygons with up to 10 sides, tell the difference between regular and irregular polygons, and recognize when shapes have equal sides or angles. Have your guided notes ready, and let's explore the math that will shape our masterpiece. In our previous few lessons, we explored points, lines, and angles. Now it's time to find out what happens when we connect several line segments and angles. What do you think they form? They make shapes! Any shape that is flat, closed, and made of straight sides is called a polygon. Polygons have specific names based on how many sides they have, and the names of a polygon can give us a clue about how many sides it has. This one's probably familiar. It's a triangle. What does tri mean? It means three, and a triangle has three sides. Check out these other shapes. Label as many of these polygons as you can with the correct name based on the number of sides. You can also use the word bank to help with your thinking. If there are any you're not sure about, that's totally okay. We'll review them together after the pause. Pause the video here and record your thinking in your guided notes. The prefix quad means four, just like how a quad bike has four wheels. So a shape with four sides is called a quadrilateral. The prefix pent means five, so a five-sided shape is called a pentagon. Hex means six, so a six-sided shape is a hexagon. Hept means seven, so a seven-sided shape is called a heptagon. Oct means eight, just like how an octopus has eight arms, and an eight-sided shape is called an octagon. Nana means nine, so a nine-sided shape is called a nonagon. And finally, the prefix deca means 10, like a decade of years. A shape with 10 sides is called a decagon. So now we know the names of all these different polygons based on how many sides they have. But are all polygons with the same number of sides shaped exactly the same? Check out these polygons. What do you notice about them? They all have four sides, so they're all quadrilaterals, but they're all shaped a little differently. Some sides are longer, some are shorter, and the angles are different too. I wonder, can we make different versions of other polygons too? Let's find out. Pause the video here and try creating two different versions of an octagon, a nonagon, and a decagon. Try changing the lengths of their sides and the size of the angles. There are lots of possibilities for how you could have drawn these polygons. Just make sure your octagons each have eight sides, your nonagons have nine sides, and your decagons have 10 sides, and that they're all closed shapes. Check out my polygons. This octagon has sides that are all different lengths, but this one has sides that are all the same length. When a polygon has side lengths and angle measurements that are all the same, we call it a regular polygon. But when they're different lengths and the angles aren't all the same, we call it an irregular polygon. When we notice polygons in the world around us, they'll often be regular polygons where the side lengths are all equal. A yield sign is a regular triangle, and the squares in a checkerboard are regular quadrilaterals. A soccer ball is made of a pattern of regular pentagons and regular hexagons, and a honeycomb, like the kind bees build, is made of regular hexagons. Sometimes it can be easy to tell if a polygon is regular, but not always. We can mark the sides and angles of polygons to help identify if they're regular or irregular. Here's a triangle that has these little marks on its sides. What do you think these marks could mean about the triangle's sides? They mean that the side lengths are the same or congruent. To show that side lengths are the same or congruent, we can use matching hatch marks like these ones. We can also use angle arcs like this to show that angle measurements are congruent. A regular polygon will have matching hatch marks on every side and matching angle arcs on every angle. An irregular polygon might have some matching hatch marks, but not on every side. And it may have a couple of matching angles, but not every angle in the shape. All right, time to practice. You'll find these two hexagons in your notes. Use hatch marks to show which sides are equal and angle arcs to show which angles are the same. Then label which hexagon is regular and which is irregular based on your markings. Pause the video here to record your thinking and your guided notes. This one is a regular hexagon because all the sides are the same length and all the angles are equal. You should have marked each side with a matching hatch mark and included angle arcs to show that they are all equal. On the other hand, this hexagon is irregular. Notice how I marked four of the sides with single hatch marks and these other two sides with two hatch marks each. This is because some of the sides have equal lengths, but they aren't all equal to each other. Now that we know how to identify and describe polygons, it's time for our interactive museum challenge. Our artwork needs to include at least one of each type of polygon. That's triangles, quadrilaterals, pentagons, hexagons, heptagons, octagons, nonagons, and decagons. It also needs to include a mix of regular and irregular polygons. Mark any regular polygons with hatch marks and angle arcs. Pause the video here to create your artwork and your guided notes. Take a look at what Mia and I came up with. Here's my design. It has all eight types of polygons, and I marked the regular ones with hatch marks and angle arcs. And here's Mia's definitely one-of-a-kind artwork, but it has everything it needs. Tomorrow, you'll use your own artwork for the first activity in the PDF. You'll label your polygons, identify which are regular or irregular, and explain how you know. So keep your artwork safe. You'll need it. So, what did we learn today, besides the fact that you don't have to be a famous artist to create your own unique artwork? Well, now you know that polygons are closed shapes with straight sides, and they're named after how many sides they have. You know that regular polygons have congruent side lengths, and irregular polygons have different side lengths. And you also know that hatch marks and angle arcs are used to show when sides and angles are congruent. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with polygons. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.